Everybody struggles. Everybody got a story. Struggle is a necessary part of growth. Without it, we would remain stagnant. You see, the key is to remain positive and persistent. You can't give up. There's no plan B. When you don't see the light at the end of the tunnel, you gotta just look around you and be still. Be thankful. You gotta find the beauty in the struggle. When I first met Jawun, he was a quiet kid, humble, laid back, easygoing. One thing I really appreciate about him, he listens. You see, as a trainer, one thing I look for in a player is comprehension. How well they respond to direction. In Jawun's case, his willingness to learn and apply have helped him grow from the shy, unranked kid that I met a few years ago to being one of the top point guards in the entire country. It's simple. We just put that work in.
My name is Jawun Evans. I'm from Greenville, South Carolina. My freshman year in high school, Southside High School in Greenville, South Carolina. You know, I came in, I had a positive mindset. You know, I was gonna come in, do good things. I was just coming off of middle school. You know, I was averaging 20 points as a freshman. We made it to Upper State Championship, and I ended up having a 28-day game, which is took us to state.
After finishing up his freshman year, Jawun decided to transfer to Legacy High School to continue playing with B.J. Jackson, his mentor and former head coach from Southside High School, where he and Jawun formed a great chemistry on and off the court.
My first game as a sophomore, I got an offer from Cincinnati, which was telling me, like, you know, that I'm pretty good at what I do. One game against one of the complete point guards, or scoring point guards that was, his name was Akil Carr. You know, fast, could shoot, could jump. We went head-to-head, and I actually came out with the win, you know, 30 points and 11 assists. That was basically telling me that I can play with anybody on this planet. Mostly all my hard work is showing them, starting to pay off. At the end of that season, I end up having 1,000 points as a sophomore. I was mentioned on ESPN, comparing me to another great point guard, which is Tyus Jones. Had the confidence, you know, everybody knew who I was in South Carolina. I just felt like I was just on top of the world at that moment. So everything was just clicking. I moved to Dallas, Texas my junior year. I came down, you know, kind of sad because I'm moving away from my friends, my family, you know, starting all over again. You know, I was basically starting from square one, you know, where I didn't want to go back to.
One thing I could really relate to him wasn't the basketball. It was more so of having to make that adjustment of being in a new environment.
Kind of started off kind of bad in school. All that was just on my mind, just making new friends, you know, meeting a new coach, you know, different style of play.
In that aspect, you know, let's try to take whatever it is that you're feeling and turn it into a positive on the basketball court to be the best version of yourself.
So it'd be nice where I just couldn't sleep, just thinking about how I'm gonna get things right. I started thinking, like, since I don't have really nobody to be with, I start being in the gym all the time, you know. Just taking my mind off of that, having friends, you know, just being in the gym, just trying to get better, you know, trying to be the best I can be.
You know, you have to fail in order to succeed. To me, my best teacher in life was the struggle. My favorite phrase is, get comfortable being uncomfortable.
Having talks with my coaches, you know, Mike Alexander, Lamont Simmons, talking to them, they just kept my spirits up, you know.
Jawun is he's a special kid. He still got a lot of work to put in, and that's what we're doing.
It was a hard road, you know, ending up at State. You know, we played against some very tough teams, you know. It was just amazing, you know, coming from where I came from and not playing at Texas for a state championship. Came out hot. I don't know what it was that game. I was making everything I put up, you know. Just coming down here and winning the state championship was very big, you know. I felt like I got that swagger back. I've always been an underdog since I've been playing, you know, playing with the Raptors.
Yeah.
We was the smallest team out there, but we was beating people by 20, you know. Last year, we had a person with over like 6'5", and that was it.
Yeah.
And we was number two team in the nation. So, I mean, I feed off of that.
Yeah.
Off of being the underdog and people telling me that I can't do stuff.
Yeah.
Or I can't shoot or stuff like that. I stay in South Carolina for the rest of the summer, you know, trying to just get my mind right. And I ended up starting to play back with the Carolina Raptors. But it's one of the best summers I had. Just being with my cousins and my friends, you know, on that team and winning too. So
this past season we ended up 50-3. We won 7 out of 9 tournaments. Lost in the Final Four, the Under Armour Finals in Atlanta, and finishing Elite Eight at Southern Jam Fest.
Played at Bob Gibbons, one of the best tournaments there was in the nation.
We finished the season number 3 in the nation, which is the highest ranking we've ever had. 5-star rankings were number 3, and Indy Hoops, I think we was number 3.
Well, I end up getting invited to the NBA Top 100. It was my first time going. I went to Kyrie Irving Point Guard Skills Academy. It was a lot of fun, you know. I ended up getting to play against Kyrie Irving, playing against an NBA player, showing me how much more work I had to put in just to get to that level. After that camp, I went to the Reebok Breakout. I feel like I did very well at that camp. You know, being a point guard vocally, you know, scoring the ball, basically getting anything I wanted when we needed it. End of my summer and going into my senior year, I ended up getting invited to the Under Armour Elite 24 game, which was on ESPN, which was very exciting for me, playing against and playing with the top players in my class.
But this is what we got right here, Jay. So what we're gonna do, okay, I want you to catch, okay, and we're moving the ball here, just in a little circular motion, okay? So we're going here, when I say shot, okay?
I start working out with Tim Martin.
I want you to adjust to where it's comfortable and then get the shot off, okay? So we're just working on that quick release, okay? Quick release. Okay, yeah, but go ahead, drop your hips, feet. All right, ready? Let's go, move it. But hips, like you're about to shoot.
It's basically just good. Work with me, you know,
shot.
Got my game better.
Good, let's go, make five. Good, quick, move. Good, warm those shoulders up. Good, shot, good.
My approach when it comes to training Jawun is focusing on developing his IQ and just building on the intangibles that he already has.
Focus. Good. Sit down. Shot. Good. Keep it in that pocket. Try to get in that pocket, keep that elbow tucked in. Shot. Good, what's that, three? Good, here. Good, shot. Four, good, right here, one more. Shot. Five, good, next spot, same thing.
Going to the Elite 24, it was in New York. It was my first time being in New York, you know, just the big city. And everything that was talked about on TV and stuff, I actually seen, you know, like Ground Zero, and just to see where the Twin Towers was, you know, just there's a lot of cultural stuff down there, and it was a great experience. I came into the game, I wasn't really nervous, you know. I was just going to just show everybody what I can do. I had the mentality where nobody could stop me.
Jawun's performance in the Elite 24 game sparked the interest of major D1 schools across the country.
All right, so, you know, I had VCU, Alabama, and Mississippi State. Coming to my senior year, I kind of took a visit to just three schools, which was USC, Southern Cal, Illinois, and Oklahoma State. All of them was very great schools.
As you can see it, it's Miami.
It's Georgia.
It's really South Carolina and VCU.
I chose Oklahoma State just because everybody was just like family, and you know, family really a big thing to me. My mom, you know, she's my heart, you know. She'd do anything for me. Even when she didn't have anything, she'd do anything for me.
I noticed about Jawun just from last year to this year right now, his drive. He played in a lot of tournaments, a lot of showcases, he went to a lot of camps, and I think that competition has helped him tremendously.
The one thing with Jawun is that he has a chance to be, just in a two-year span, he has a chance to be one of the best ones I've coached.
He's a little bit more serious in the classroom, he's focused, and he's just a great young man.
You know, I'm seeing him grow as a man just in, you know, the time that we've had, and to see him start loving basketball in a different enlightenment is really a joy to watch, and really a joy to see.
We've been working pretty hard the last year or so. We've stepped it up. He's been in there getting his weight training, getting his cardio, getting ready. Also to finish out this senior season of high school and get ready for college.
For me, I'm not worried as far as when it comes to Jawun, because I know for a fact he's gonna make that transition, because he's done it on every level. You put him in any situation and he's gonna be successful.
I know he's excited about it, I'm excited about it, but we just wanna be ready for it, because it's gonna be a rude awakening. Nothing's gonna come easy. Put in a lot of work to get to where he is now.
Now I'm starting a new chapter in my life, you know, being signed and committed to Oklahoma State. it was a blessing.
It's gonna be more of a grind. I think he's ready for it, and I know I'm ready for it, and everybody back home is ready for it because they're pulling for it.
You know, just all the hard work is starting to pay off.
Unfortunately, everybody's story doesn't come to a happy ending. But if you remain persistent, still thankful, there is a light at the end of the tunnel. You'll find the beauty in the struggle.
Love yours. Love yours. No such thing. No such thing as a life that's better than yours. No such thing as a life that's better than yours.
Love yours.
No such thing as a life that's better than yours. No such thing, no such thing.
Heart beating fast, letting you know that he alive. Fake victims, mad snakes, snakes in the grass, letting you know that he arrived. Don't be sleeping on your level, cause it's beauty in the struggle.
Beauty, beauty
goes for all y'all. It's beauty in the struggle.
Beauty, beauty.
Yeah. It's beauty in the struggle, ugliness in the success. Hear my words and listen to my signal of distress. I grew up in the city and know sometimes we had less compared to somebody.